Hey guys, welcome back to, yes, another Dollar Tree DIY. And in today's video, I will be sharing 5 DIYs using Dollar Tree floral. Yes, please. I personally think the Dollar Tree has some amazing floral pieces. I absolutely love their little floral picks where you get like a little pine cone and a pumpkin. I think those are amazing deals for a dollar. I always stock up every year, and I actually pulled out a tub that I had with a lot of floral and I was trying to reuse some from last year. So if you stocked up on some Dollar Tree floral, or if you have some in your stash, you want to put it to some good use this year, you've come to the right video. And I will be sharing 5 different ways to use it. Before we jump into today's video, I do want to let you guys know that I have a giveaway going on right now, and I will be giving away a farmer's market calendar from the Dollar Tree. Y'all, it is absolutely gorgeous, and I do have an extra one on hand ready to give away to one lucky subscriber. If you would like to enter that giveaway or you want more details about it, I will leave the link to the video in the description box below. So be sure to check that out if you would like a chance to win that calendar. So without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into these DIYs.
Alrighty, let's go ahead and jump into DIY number 1, and that will be a fall table centerpiece using this tray right here from the Dollar Tree. It comes in silver and I believe gold, but I will be painting mine with the Waverly chalk paint in white, giving it 2 good coats, and then going in with the Waverly chalk paint in truffle and giving it a slight dry brush. Okay, while the tray is drying, let's go ahead and move on to some little risers. I am taking some of the Dollar Tree like Jenga dupe. These are their tumbling tower blocks, and I am going to glue 3 of them together. And I'm actually going to do that 4 times and then glue all 4 sets together. And I did do this process 3 full times so that I could have 3 wood risers. Okay, let's go ahead and prep some of our floral. Dollar Tree has some amazing floral pieces. I used some floral picks, some maple leaves, and I'm just going to trim all of the pieces off. I did go ahead and use some lamb's ear from Walmart just because I had it on hand. You definitely don't need it. I also had some orange pumpkin picks that are an amazing find at the Dollar Tree as well. So let's just go ahead and get this floral prepped, and let's move on to the next step, which is putting this beautiful centerpiece together. Just wait and see. Here we have our tray. We are going to set the risers down just in the middle, and then I will be placing these adorable little hurricane candle holders from the Dollar Tree right on top. Now, I didn't glue anything down. If you wanted to, you could definitely use some E6000 and glue your wood risers to the tray and then your hurricane candle holders to the wood risers so that you have something that is very, very sturdy. Since I do want to be able to reuse all of these items, I did not glue anything down. Alrighty, now I'm just going to pop in some floral, some lamb's ear, some of the picks from the Dollar Tree, and now I'll just go ahead and play around with some spacing and some layering on both sides of the centerpiece. And here is a complete look at DIY number 1. I love the way it turned out, and I love how everything is interchangeable. Since I didn't glue anything down, I can reuse all of these items or switch the floral out. Moving right into DIY number 2, and we will be making a small floral arrangement. So I will be using 2 of these little wooden crates from the Dollar Tree, and I did give them a good coat of the Waverly Antique Wax. Once it dried, I just took the Dollar Tree sanding sponge and sanded down each little crate. Y'all, sanding it down really makes a difference and just gives it that really rustic look. So here is a look at what the crates are look like, and I think they turned out great. So once my crates are ready, I'm just going to take some hot glue, and I would recommend some E6000 so that your project could last longer, and glue both of these crates together. If you missed it, I did post a large Dollar Tree DIY floral arrangement. I will leave the link to that video in the description box below. Okay, so now I'm taking two pieces of the Dollar Tree floral foam and some leftover buffalo plaid ribbon that I had on hand, and I'm just going to cover the sides of the floral foam just because you can see it through the crate. If that doesn't bother you, go ahead and skip this step. And then taking a variety of floral picks from the Dollar Tree, I have some sunflowers, some maple leaves. I also have some of the wired stem burlap leaves and some of the adorable cute little pumpkin picks. I'm just going to go ahead and trim all of these off and get ready to put this floral arrangement together. To finish up this DIY, I will be taking this little galvanized word that says harvest. It does come in a 3-pack from the Dollar Tree, popping some hot glue to the back of it and adding it onto the crate. And I think it is just that perfect little touch this DIY needed. Alrighty, and here is a look at DIY number 2, and I think it turned out absolutely adorable. Let's go ahead and move on to DIY number 3, and it is going to be a fall tree, and I am so obsessed with it. Now, I did see this idea on Pinterest, and I have a ton of fall floral that I wanted to use up this year, so I thought, okay, I totally need this in my house. You will need a plunger from the Dollar Tree and 15 of the maple leaf floral picks. Okay, so this DIY is super simple. All you're going to do is take the stem of your maple leaves, and you are going to apply some hot glue to your plunger and press your stem down. Now, you only want to work in sections. I recommend only applying 2 stems, letting them cool completely, and then moving on and adding 2 more, let them cool, so on and so on. I initially tried to apply 3 of the stems at first, and by the time I got to the 3rd one, the first one was popping off, so highly recommend working in sections of 2. Okay, once you get all of your stems glued onto your plunger, it will look something like this. And then I will be taking 1 package of this mesh tubing that looks like rope. If you don't have any of this, you could also use some nautical rope from the Dollar Tree, as well as any burlap ribbon that you have on hand. And then I'm going to secure this down to the plunger. So I'm not going to add hot glue to this entire piece of mesh tubing. I'm just going to secure down the first section here and then twist the tubing around and just apply hot glue here and there just to make sure that it does stay. I am doing this because I only applied 14 of those stems to the plunger. I did keep the last one. I am going to trim it and then pop in some pieces here along the mesh tubing so that the tree looks a little bit more realistic. I will be popping my floral tree into this little basket from the Target dollar spot that I got maybe 2 years ago. You can use any bucket, basket that you have on hand, or the Dollar Tree does have a great variety of little baskets and pails, especially really cute galvanized ones. I didn't have any moss on hand, but if you do, you could totally apply some to the bottom of your tree. Oh, and I forgot to mention, I did use some rocks that we had outside to hold my plunger down. So you definitely want to do that because the tree is quite top heavy. So if you have any rocks outside, I highly recommend doing that. And then I did apply some Excelsior around my tree. Okay, I'm sorry for the angle, but my tree is very, very large and I was trying to get it in frame. Now what you're going to do is start separating your maple leaves, and you're just going to pull them each and every which way to just make your tree look very, very full. I did go ahead and take a package of the leaves from the Dollar Tree, the little loose leaves, and I did apply some down at the bottom so it looked like our fall leaves were falling. I think that's absolutely adorable. And y'all, it's as easy as that. Here is a look at my fall Dollar Tree DIY tree, and I think it turned out so stinking cute. Okay, moving along to DIY number 4. And I will be creating a little candle ring. You could also just use this as a little mini wreath. I am taking some of this beaded garland from the Dollar Tree. It is wired, so love that. I'm just going to shape it into a circle and just twist it together so that it holds its shape. If you already have some small wire wreaths from the Dollar Tree, you could totally skip this step and just use that. Now I'm just taking some extra floral that I had on hand, trimming it down to size, and I'm going to fill this garland up. I did pre-cut some floral wire, and I'll be using it kind of like you would pipe cleaners on a much larger wreath. I'll be attaching my stems and floral picks using the floral wire. I do recommend cutting your floral wire into longer pieces. So once you attach your first round of leaves, you have extra wire to continue to add on to those spots just so that you make your little wreath look larger and fuller. So I'm just going to go ahead and pop in just a variety of floral from the Dollar Tree. I have some sunflowers, some maple leaves, some berries. I do have some pine cones from some of the floral picks from the Dollar Tree, as well as some of the mini pumpkins. So I'm just going to go ahead and let you guys watch what I'm doing, and I just keep adding and adding to make my little wreath look fuller. Okay, I definitely wanted to add some pumpkins to this little wreath, so I have these little pumpkin clips from the Dollar Tree. Once I started to add them on there, I thought maybe 3 of them are just a little too large for this small mini wreath. So I took one off and I pulled these much smaller little pumpkin picks from the Dollar Tree, and they do have a wired stem, which is perfect to add on to this little mini wreath. So I added one on and I thought, maybe a little too small. So I took some of those leftover leaves that I had from my previous DIY. They come in a package from the Dollar Tree for $1. I took 3 of them, held them together, clipped them in the middle, and stuck that little stem from the mini pumpkin straight through. And oh my goodness, I thought this was perfect. It definitely is going to make my wreath look a little bit fuller, especially in that little place that looked like it needed a little something. And I'm just going to attach the wire to the wreath. And y'all, that was perfection. There are a ton of possibilities to use this little mini wreath. You can definitely use it as a candle ring. You can put it under a cake stand. You can use it on a picture frame. Just get creative and crafty, but let me know what you think about it in the comments down below. Let's go ahead and move on to, oh my goodness, our last DIY, DIY number 5, and this one is going to be oh so easy. We are going to be putting together another floral arrangement, but using a container that you already have at home. So look around your home and think about what you could use to pop a floral arrangement into. I decided to use this little watering can. Well, it's actually not little. It's a little bit larger. It is from the brand Opal House from Target, regular price $20. But my mom actually got it for me at Dirt Cheap. They sell things at rock bottom prices. And she picked up this little watering can for $5, y'all. Oh my goodness, I am so obsessed with it. And I knew I just had to use it for fall time. So I'm just going to stuff it with some tissue paper first because it is very large and very deep. Once I get it filled with some tissue paper, I will be taking some green floral foam from the Dollar Tree and a variety of Dollar Tree floral and leaves. I had a ton and actually just about used up all of the floral that I had on hand, from sunflowers to maple leaves to berries. I did want to add some pumpkins to this floral arrangement, and I was out of these little pumpkin picks, so I decided to make some of my own. I have a set of these little pumpkins. They were from the Target dollar spot from last year, but my mom picked them up from Dirt Cheap, and I think she got them for about $1. So I just took some of those leftover stems that I had used from the previous DIYs. I was just going to toss them, so I thought, hey, I could repurpose these so that I could pop them into the floral arrangement. I did go ahead and take a much larger pumpkin as well from the Dollar Tree, pop it on one of those stems I was going to toss out, and popped it into this floral arrangement, and I just loved it. Last but not least, I thought this arrangement needed just a little bit of something, so I did pop in some raffia. And y'all, it's as easy as that. Another DIY is done, and I think it turned out so cute.
Alrighty, that is a wrap for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing 5 DIYs using Dollar Tree floral. Please let me know which one was your favorite in the comments down below. If I had to pick, I really, really love the watering can and just like popping all of the Dollar Tree floral that I had left over. I just thought that was so cute. But I absolutely love the way the fall tree came out. So it's just so hard to pick. But I would love to hear your favorites in the comments down below. If you enjoyed this video and if you love my Dollar Tree DIYs, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. It really helps my channel out and I appreciate you taking some of your time to spend it with me. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave and hit that notification bell so that you won't miss my next upload, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.